Welcome to The Real McCoy Show, where we bring on top industry leaders and discuss what makes them The Real McCoy. Now, your host, Stephen McCoy.
Hello, and thank you so much for tuning in for today's episode of The Real McCoy Show. And man, have I got a special guest today. So whenever I said, this guy gets you turned on, don't get crazy thoughts. That's his logo. That's his slogan. So I have Gabe Abchar, the founder and CEO of Utility Concierge. So, Gabe, welcome to the show today.
Hey, man, great to be here. Good to see you.
Awesome, man. You know, I was telling some other people in the studio earlier that we've known each other for some years, and man, I can't tell you the original date, but I know over the years you've definitely helped a lot of our clients get the process of moving into the home, getting it a smooth transition. Because I was just on the phone with Leanna a few minutes ago, my wife, and my lovely wife, and she said, man, I remember every time we move, the worst part is calling the utility providers and getting everything turned on. And it's, you know, you're on hold for 45 minutes to an hour. You got an abundance of things going on, but yet without utilities, you're going to move into this home and won't be able to utilize it, right? So so welcome to the show today.
Thank you so much for being here. Great to be here. That's actually my favorite question to ask.
Yeah.
When I tell somebody what we do, hey, we help people set up all their home services and utilities when you move in a new home, but then right away I ask them, so when's the last time you moved? Oh, we moved 2 years ago.
Right.
Great. Well, tell me about your experience setting up your home service and utilities. And I just sit back and let them ramble, because it's never like, oh my God, it was so great.
Yeah.
I called, it took me like 5 minutes unless they used us.
Right.
But yeah, it's always a nightmare. And I just go, really? Oh, okay. Well,
wow.
That's the best way to explain what we do.
Yeah.
That pain, that feeling, that frustration, we take it away.
Exactly right. And so on that statement, so what led you to be the founder of Utility Concierge? Was it that pain point? Is it an experience that you experienced personally? Or what led up and the light bulb went off one day? No pun intended, but the light went off one day and you said, man, there's a need here, and I'm going to create a company to help, you know, fill this need and help people out. When did that happen exactly? And how did you come up with that idea?
Yes. So I had a satellite installation company. We still actually have that today, but we had a satellite installation company. We did work for Dish Network and DirecTV, and we would do their fulfillment work. So we would go out, send crews out to do the install. And one of the things that we were measured on, one of the KPIs that we were measured on, was install rate.
Yeah.
And so, look, we didn't get paid. The guys didn't get paid unless the job got in. So we started digging into it and figuring out, you know, what's going on? Why are these jobs not getting in?
Yeah.
And we really came to realize that most of the jobs that didn't get in were from people that were moving. So they would have their TV and no electricity, electricity, no TV, because the movers got stuck.
Yeah.
And they would be sitting there, and we just recognized that pain point. And so in 07, I bought a home security company, and with the idea of like, hey, I can sell satellite and I can sell security, let's go sell people stuff, right? and it was good because I got to get back to my sales kind of background.
Right.
But really quickly, I found out that, you know, it was just a different message. Like, hey, Steve, send me your people and we'll sell them satellite and security, right?
That's always the best help.
That's not a good
look.
Call
me, I'm going to close these people down.
Right.
They will not hang up till they buy from us.
Yeah, so not a good look. And so... In 2009, Utility Concierge was born with a different message of like, you know, Steve, senior clients will help them. We'll help them through this very stressful time, top five most stressful things that you can do in your life.
Yeah.
And we'll help them get through that. And we did that on a few principles. Number one, the power of choice, meaning we're never going to say you have to get this, right?
Gotcha.
Whatever you want, whatever you need, that's what we're going to get you, right?
Perfect.
We have complete options of everything in the market. We're partnering with all the major companies. Number two is transparent communication. We know what they're going through. We know what the moving process is like. We know when we need to turn them on, when things need to happen. So we're going to talk to them. I like to say we're going to talk to them like They're our best friends, and we'd recommend things that we'd recommend to our mothers.
Makes
right?
sense, yeah.
And then last and final thing that I think is the best is that we're 100% referral-based business. And so we're going to give the credit back to you.
Wow.
So when you send a client over,
yeah.
when we call them, it's like, you know, hey, this utility concierge, we're calling on Steve's behalf. We're calling yeah. on the McCoy team's behalf
right.
to make you look good. Right.
Awesome.
And so yep. those three things are what we started with, man. We've been rocking and rolling for 10 years and
wow.
and making people smile.
Yeah, that's what it's about. And, you know, it was a couple of years ago. I saw you actually on Channel 4 and they were interviewing you because your company was appointed as one of the fastest growing companies in North Texas. And I believe a part of that episode, they had mentioned heavy on veterans, helping veterans get back to work. And I just want to commend you for that and also congratulate you. That's you know, a huge honor. And right now on your team, I'm pre-COVID, let's go pre-COVID because
sure.
we haven't really talked about post-COVID, but prior to COVID, how many team members do you currently have and where are you guys at in that?
Sure. So COVID's been really interesting for us. So we were hiring very aggressively before COVID.
Right.
We love talking to veterans. When we see a veteran application, we definitely want to make sure we take another look at it and
awesome.
want to talk to them.
Yep.
But then, so COVID hit, you know, right in kind of the, when it was starting to pick back up
yeah.
and we switched to work from home immediately. We pulled the trigger on a Friday and everybody was live working from home on a Monday. Thank God. It was
yeah.
amazing.
Wow.
Our team was amazing. Everybody stayed in their lane. They did what they were supposed to.
Yep.
And we have been kicking butt from home yeah. during this time. And so we were about 60 before COVID. And then we've probably hired in the last 3 months, we've hired about 18 people.
Nice, man.
Yeah.
These are all fulfillment jobs that, you know, you train. Walk us through like a new hire, you bring them in and then you're going to introduce them to you mentioned a minute ago, KPIs. For those of you who may or may not know, that's key point indicators. So we got to keep it broad here,
right,
Gabe.
Okay,
so
we're
not on the corporate
yeah,
level
right,
today.
Right,
so let's
right.
back it down a little.
Metrics, data, ways
yeah,
to
yeah.
track things. If you don't know where you're going, then anywhere's yeah. good, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
It's like a ship will take you anywhere.
Exactly.
Yeah, exactly. You got to know which way you're going. So with that being said, on your processes, so you mentioned relationships with all providers. And where I live is a mud district, so
mm-hmm.
we do not have a choice. So how do you balance on these different sectors that have municipal utility districts that are appointed to someone? Like when I lived in Craig Ranch, same thing.
Sure.
We didn't have a choice on electric. It was where we are now is... Man, Grayson County, had to think about
oh,
that.
Oh yeah, GCC,
second, but,
yeah.
So with that being said, there are other ways that you can save on utilities. And we pride our show, the Real McCoy Show, on bringing resources. And we've had, you know, insurance brokerage. We've
mm-hmm.
had a mortgage guy with Brian Phillips with Supreme Lending. And, you know, and this is another key point, you know, like you said in your,
sure.
your I love your USP. It's like, turns you on. I'm like, what? Wait a second. Let me rewrite that. Let me reread that
yeah,
again. What's going on there?
We just did a rebrand and
yeah.
it was
yeah.
an interesting conversation to go with that. But but if you look at some of the big brands,
yeah.
they always have some type of
hook
or innuendo.
Yeah. Yeah.
But the cool thing about that tagline, we turn you on, it works for our
all
clients, it works for
yeah.
our customers, it works for our people that we're hiring, we're gonna turn your career on.
Awesome.
And so it was a hot topic, but
yeah.
I like it. I love it.
That's cool, man. So So when you're looking at, you mentioned before you had a satellite fulfillment. So you went in, you installed them, and then you also may or may not still, do you still have that
sure.
alarm company?
Yeah, we yeah. still have the satellite
Secure.
Installation company. And so it's the main reason we have it here locally is so we can control the experience of the customer.
Yeah,
right.
Makes sense.
So if we're installing that here locally, that level of service that utility concierge gives, that level
right.
of experience, we give that to the customer. So that's
wow.
why we own what we can.
That's fantastic. And so, I mentioned in a post earlier that it may be time for a utility checkup. So
yeah.
it's not only for people who are moving to a,
sure.
and when I say new home, that could be next home, that could be, you know, you're moving to a 1938 home. The point is you're moving. So
yeah.
skip that hassle and the burden of all the different phone calls you need to make. And what's the best way to get started with either a utility checkup or turning new systems on? Is that?
Well, so... New people that are moving is going to be your clients, right?
Yep.
I mean,
yep.
obviously we got the
yeah, we got the
home
book.
Fast for
yeah,
top
yeah, it's about to fall off my prop
yeah.
there. Hold on, you got to be fast.
Yeah,
all right.
Obviously
yes.
they're
yeah.
going to be coming from you guys, so we're going
yep.
to take care of them like they're like our, like they're a family and make awesome. You look like a rock star. But for people that have been in new homes, we have a product called Utility Checkup.
Okay.
And so what that looks like is, look, we're in our houses, things are on credit card auto pay. Yeah. We don't really look at the bill. You get your bill and you're in a regulated area, so you don't really have a choice. But people that are in deregulated areas, they look at their bill and look, they probably look at it and they cuss it for a little bit.
Yeah.
But then they go,
we've been there.
Yeah. But then they go, you know, I'm not going to spend the hour, two, three, whatever, researching the 45 different electricity companies and going through the marketing jargon to figure out what the best deal is to save $50 a month, right? Or save $100 a month.
Yeah.
It, you should, but we just don't do it. It's human nature. So that's what we do. We come in, if you're in the home for a while, we'll do a utility checkup and we'll look at all your services and see where we can save you some money.
That's awesome.
And that's electricity, TV, internet, and home security. And really, in this day and age, it's really home automation, smart home.
Yeah, that's awesome. Yeah. What about on alarm providers? Is it you have your own servicing company, but also do you work with other major brands? Just to name a few, like what would
those be? Same deal. Yeah. So we're partnering with all the major brands, Vivint, Brinks, ADT, Guardian. Okay. Is a really, really great partner of ours. And again, we're almost brand agnostic, right? Like we ask the questions, what do you want? What are you looking for? What are your needs? And then we present you with your options, right? If you say you want a security system, okay, great, man, here's six pages of stuff to go look through.
Yeah.
That's not a service, right? And
so
we sit back in the middle and we're that trusted advisor,
Sense.
So what do you want? Great, let me go pay with a great company that we've vetted that has great pricing, that has a great product, and most importantly, has a great customer service.
That's awesome. And that's, you know, the full fulfillment of, you know, moving into your home and having the automation, like you mentioned, that's where everyone's going.
Sure.
And I've been bucking the system. Our daughter's name is Alexa, so she was born in 2011. So it was pre-Alexa, but she always says, Dad, the kids at school are teasing me. They're saying Alexa this, Alexa that. And I'm like, embrace it. Everyone knows your name. I was like, I wish everyone knew my name. You know, embrace it. You're worldwide, babe. You know, that's amazing. But I always call her Amazing Grace because her middle name's Alexa Grace. So
Beautiful.
I always call her Amazing Grace. But so with Alexa and all the home automation, so how far into that are you guys involved? Do you take their profile and vet them and they match them with them being the customer, the new client? Through those steps, you present them with one, two, or three options of different providers, and the client is only making one call. Can you walk us through that? Because so I basically logged into your website and take it from there. So I fill out the form. And
So if you're coming from
Steven, and then from there.
Yeah, if you're if you're not coming from a partner, our partners have portals. We have integrations into their systems and APIs, so that comes over. But if you're looking out there and you want to do a utility checkup, you want to try to get a security system or home automation, just go to utilityconcierge.com, click the Get Connected button, fill it out, and then once that happens, it comes into our system, and we'll have a concierge reach out to you and go through that and figure out what your needs are. If you're doing a checkup, we'll start with the electricity, see if we can save some money. And we'll walk through each individual product. And either or, if you're on the new move side or utility checkup side, once you say, you know, once we have our conversation, look, we can knock this out in 15, 20 minutes, right?
Wow.
So because
That's
we're simple,
awesome.
It's simple.
Yeah.
It's to the point we're not, I tell my team, I hate the word call center.
Yeah.
I don't want anyone to ever think that they're calling a call center, right? And so we're gonna be quick, efficient. And then once you make the selections, we're going to go to work making the connections. You can go about your day, and we'll get everything scheduled for you.
That was smooth right there. So you make the selection, we make the connection.
Yeah.
See, so he's turned on. He's making selections and connections.
That's it.
Gabe, so tell us a little bit about your family for a minute. We talk business
for a minute.
Yeah, man. So one time I saw this guy. We were on the plane to a Steamboat, and I'm like, Gabe, what's going on? He's like, man, it's Country Fest. It's coming up.
Oh, yeah.
So we go to Steamboat, like your family. Actually, we ran into each other there like a couple of years in a row.
Yeah.
That's our
God, I miss that,
every
man.
Year we go, our family for New Year's, and we hit that. We try to leave right before Country Music Festival. So we hit it for New Year's. We catch the fireworks show and the torch glow going down Steamboat down the peak there. So
yeah.
So what other than, so we know you guys like to ski. So tell us a little bit about how many kids and
how you've been married,
all that good stuff.
Yeah, I got two kids and a beautiful wife, Veronica.
Awesome.
Andrew's actually going to be 11 tomorrow and Renee's 9.
All right.
They love to ski. They absolutely just, you know, Andrew tears down the mountain and Renee takes her time. So
yeah.
They love to ski. We play golf. Andrew plays baseball. Renee's in dance. And we really love to travel. This whole COVID thing has been has been a situation for us because I want to give my kids experiences. So we love to travel.
Yeah,
so
awesome.
But yeah, other than that, man, it's homeschooling's been interesting. How's homeschooling been for your kids? How
well,
many kids do you have again?
I have one daughter, Alexa, and you know, I was not a teacher. I was more of a referee because my wife wants things done a certain way, and she's more of the structured. I'm like, well, it'll get done at this time and this time. Leanna's like, nope, up, we're gonna do the Skype thing or whatever, log in, get the itinerary, get it done by noon, and then Alexa, you can go and do what you do during the day.
Yeah.
So she finished with A's. I'm not, you know, she's always been an A honor roll student, and that's been a blessing, and she definitely gets that from my wife, my beautiful wife, not from me. So I always say, you know, hey, I passed. You know, it doesn't matter the grade, but grades do matter. I respect that. And we want the best for our children.
Sure.
Right? So Leanna just told me actually earlier on the phone that the new ruling from the Governor Abbott is that schools will be opening. So, you know, check with whatever school you're going to. But I believe they're going to have an option to either homeschool or go to school. And I told Leanna we'll buy hazmat suits if we need to, because she needs that interaction, even if it's in a bubble.
Yeah.
You know, you still need human interaction besides us parents, right? So we made it through it. I wouldn't say it was an enjoyable process, because I had to get in and referee in between them and say, guys, it's not that serious. Let's just fill in the blanks here, you know? So
yeah, we had a good experience, I think. So I got two, but it was funny to see, and my wife did a great job of being a teacher. I didn't have to deal with too much of it.
Yeah.
But I did know that when I got a question, I had to ask Alexa, I'm the wrong person to be teaching our kids.
The bot Alexa, not
right. Not your daughter.
Yeah.
But it was funny, they switched roles. So Andrew has my brain, which is, he's always on, he's always going, possibly sometimes hard to concentrate in school.
Yeah.
And Renee's the teacher's pet, the straight A student.
Wow.
And so the roles flipped. Like Andrew would get up in the morning, 8:30, he's on the iPad, he's knocking his stuff out because he realized, man, if I can get this stuff done by noon, I got the rest of the day to do whatever I want.
That's awesome.
And then Renee, we would look up, and because we're focused on Andrew, we'd look up and be like, Renee, what's going on?
You're never
like
logged in.
You're like six lessons behind. What's going on? And so, but all in all, to be honest with you, man, I loved it being home, and it almost, you know, I sat back and I was like, is this what life's supposed to be like, right? Is this a true work-life balance? Because, I mean, work from home, think about it. I mean, work from home, I mean, you get up an hour later, or you get up when you normally get up, and you're just relaxed in the morning, right? You can
Makes
have
sense.
Your morning. You're not going crazy with the kids. You can spend quality time. They start doing their homework. We start working.
Yeah.
And then our breaks are you get to go hold your daughter.
Exactly.
You get to go take a walk with your daughter. You get to have lunch with your family.
Ride the bike.
Yeah, get out. Yeah, get out and move.
Right.
And then you get back to work in the afternoon, and then the day's over with at where it should be, like four or five, right?
Yeah.
Instead of running them around like crazy to all these events and all these,
all the
sports. So it was a different thing. I kind of zoomed out and like tried to appreciate as much as I could.
More perspective on what it was truly about. And, you know, it's definitely a lot of people did some adjusting, and, you know, it was a shock and awe for all of us. We're all like, still don't know what the true purpose, and you know, I'm not going to go into that. This is not a political show, but
we're not on top of that.
Yeah, we're not going into that, but at the end of the day, it brought us all home and had more quality time with our family. And you're right, Gabe, that is a true work-life balance when you can plug in, be productive for 45 minutes to an hour, have a 15-minute, 20-minute break, and be at home, be present,
and then
from there plug back in and do some more work. And you know, as a real estate agent going and showing property, that was presented its own challenges, and doing a lot of stuff virtually. So we had to the perfect term, and that's the term of COVID, is pivot. So yes, we pivoted just like everyone else. We had to do everything virtually, and you know, it was a lot of adjustment, but maybe that's the disruption our industry needed. As far as real estate agent, I'm not speaking to other industries, but because there are better systems that could be utilized, and technologies are already there. And we were just set in our patterns and our old ways. And, you know, that's one reason I wanted to, you know, invite you onto the show and, you know, have you tell our audience more about, you know, making things, not only saving you money, but let's go back to what truly matters, and that's time. Because you spend 45 minutes on the phone with four different providers, then, you know, you're 3.5 hours, 4 hours in, then that's 4 hours you could have been doing something else more productive or being with your family. And you can't put a price on the time,
exactly,
right? Because no matter 10 millionaire, 100 millionaire, or guy with 100 bucks in his pocket, we all have 24 hours in the day.
100%, so, man. You know, that's, yeah, it was a good perspective. And then back to the technology thing, I think there was a lot of things are going to change because, you know, people were on the fence, right? Yeah. Should I do this? Do I trust this technology? You know, and people were forced into it, right? I mean, for us, we had been talking about work from home for a year, right? We were just about to launch it, but you had to, you know, you had to get to a certain level and earn it.
Yeah.
We've been talking about virtual training. We had three start groups. So we had three people come in during this, three groups come in this during this time of about, you know, 8 to 10. We trained them virtually on Zoom, and they're outperforming. They're doing better than they were in the office.
That's a lot. That speaks volumes, right?
Yeah.
There.
So it was a weird time. I'm, you know, a little bit concerned about the 30,000 square foot office lease we just signed, but I'm not going to sacrifice production. And not only only their production, but their happiness. Everybody was so, our culture was, everybody was so happy.
Yeah.
And we, you know, we would keep everybody engaged via Google Hangouts and do happy hours and things like that.
Yeah.
And people were just, our team was so happy, man. And it really made me feel really, really good.
That's awesome. And so as far as, other than utility concierge, I read up some stuff. So you're on the board of, is it the board of employment or what is the
EO?
EO. Can you speak a little bit about that? Because there's obviously concern and of employment and things coming back, and what are the true numbers? And sorry to spring that on you, but you know, I heard something about that, and I just want to ask you: are the numbers true, and what's happening here in Dallas more so?
Like, so I can't, on the streets. I can't speak to that. EO is called, is stands for Entrepreneur Organization.
Okay.
So I've been in that for 8 years now. And so the last 2 years I've been the learning chair. So here in Dallas, we have about 150 members. It's a global organization, about 15,000 members globally. Mm. And it's all founders, CEOs of companies. And so EO Dallas is an amazing organization.
Yeah.
It's been countless things for me that's helped me through my business career.
Yeah.
And but yeah, I've been in their learning chair for 2 years, and so we plan events. And so come April, it was interesting. We kicked off a bunch of Zoom events, and that got really old really quick.
Right.
And so we scaled that back, but people got used to it, man. I mean, I think there's definitely Zoom overload, but there's something about the speakers changed their tone, they changed their content, and people came together and they got used to it. But if you're an entrepreneur, look it up. It's eodallas.org.
Awesome,
amazing group that can help you grow your business and just put you in a room with like-minded people. That's the biggest thing. I call it, there's a different energy when you're around your people.
That's
right?
It.
And so it's a great community.
Yeah, it was a different environment versus, you know, I'm just gonna go ahead and say it because I started to say it. It's a different environment from Golden Corral and the Ritz, right? So, you know, if you're out hanging out in a certain crowd and you're looking to grow your business, it's better to surround yourself with people that have already been there and done that and blazed that trail. And Russell Bronson talks about, you know, a lot of entrepreneurs have arrows in their back because they went on their own path and they got hit along the way. It's best just to tap into someone's knowledge that's already done it.
Why do it again? Like, go to the, I tell my son that, like, man, because you know, how's your daughter?
She's 9. She'll be 9 in 2 weeks.
Yeah. Right around my son's age. And I'm like, listen, man, if you're trying to figure stuff out on your own, it's silly. If it's already been done, go find the person that's done it, learn from their mistakes, and use it as a stepping stone. And the people that you go ask, they're going to be willing to help you.
Exactly.
The right people.
Leaders
will.
Are. Yeah. 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 They want to give back, and they don't have a, you know, basically lack of mindset. They think of abundance, right? So if they can help you, that's great. If you come and challenge them, they know there's more business for everyone. And so that's what I found in the top, you know, 5% of agents, anyone that you go and ask, you would think, man, why would they share everything about their business? It's because people don't really go and apply everything that they're told to do. Sure. And so they know they're not going to do everything, but if they do part, they will start to jump up those runs on the ladder and go a little higher and a little higher.
So, yeah, man. So yeah. It's either scarcity or abundancy.
Yeah.
Right?
One, and you can pick the side, right?
Yep.
Yeah. There's also that story about the good wolf and the bad wolf, and whichever one wins is the one you feed. That refers to your good thoughts or bad thoughts. So,
amen.
Shout out to my friend Valente Martinez, who told me about the good wolf and bad wolf.
Nice.
So it's an old parable. But well, Gabe, man, thank you so much. Is there a benefit to going on and doing the checkup? Have you seen like a big shift? Is it the $50 savings? Is it 100? Is it case by case scenario? What's kind of the norm, if you would say, if there is such a norm on savings
so
that
I think
a client should go and check it out?
So people are home more, right? And I think they want to make their house better if they can, right?
Yeah.
You're gonna spend time in your house. I'd be interested to see the numbers on home improvement in across the nation. But I know Home Depot is going crazy. But
exactly.
You're in your home more. You're noticing more stuff,
yeah.
And you want to be comfortable. The biggest tip I can give is do the utility checkup, but then tap into technology. Do a smart home. Do a smart home system. In fact, can I give an offer to your
your
people?
Sure, man.
So look, if you go to utilityconcierge.com and go click the Get Connected button, and when you're filling it out, just put The Real McCoy Show.
There you go.
Right?
The Real McCoy Show.
You do that, I'm going to give them a free thermostat.
Okay.
Right? A free thermostat that you can program that goes through your phone. So if you get a smart home system, we'll throw in
awesome.
A thermostat for you. That's the easiest way to save money.
Right. There you go. Because it uses it actually learns your patterns, right? You program it, but also it learns your patterns as
It'll
well.
Learn some patterns, you right. program, but the program's right. super easy.
Okay.
And the best thing, it works with Alexa. So at night, listen, man, at night, it's the best thing.
Yeah.
You go,
nighttime.
I go, Alexa, good night. My lights go off, my door locks, my thermostat sets, my, all the alarm sets, right? And then if you get hot during the night, you just roll over and go, hey, Alexa, turn it down to whatever. And it's interesting, but it's great. And it's super simple.
Yeah.
Back in the day, that would have cost thousands of thousands of dollars.
Exactly.
It's very, very, very affordable.
Well, cool, man. So, any dreams, any goals coming up that you guys, any dream vacations that were put off because of COVID, or where you guys going over as soon as things open back up? I know things are partly open, but
sure.
we're not daring to get on a plane. We're actually going to drive to Florida. So, man, that's going to be crazy. That's going to be a drive. I think it's 12 or 14 hours. So we've driven to Orange Beach. How about you guys? You got something coming up?
We're going to go. We have a little place in Michigan. And so we're going to go there. We went there last year for the first time for July, and it was awesome. It was a little bit of what we just went through 3 months. There's little technology, lots of reading, lots of outdoor stuff, just really great family time. So I'm really pumped and looking forward to that.
Cool. Well, man, thank you so much for being on the show, and thank you for presenting that offer to our audience. And
I'd love to take care of
UtilityConcierge.com is the website. And Gabe Abshire, you heard it from the man himself, and he found that pain point that we were all going through. So stop the madness, as Mr. Wonderful would say, and go to his website anytime you're making that transition into the next home. Until next time, I'm Steve McCoy, your host, and we'll see you next week. Thank you so much.
Thanks for watching today's episode. Check out the links in the description to get more detail on our guest today and all things North Texas real estate.